諦めんなよ、諦めんなお前。どうしてそこでやめるんだ、そこで。もう少し頑張ってみろよ。ダメダメダメ、目諦めたら周りのこと思うよ。応援する人たちのこと思ってみろって。あともうちょっとのところなんだから。俺だってこのマイナス10度のところ縮みが取れるって頑張ってんだよ。絶対やってみろ。必ず目標達成できる。だからこそネバギバ。
My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody just calls me Ciotti. You can call me what you'd like. It's raining in Atlanta, so we're stuck inside. Jamie comes on in an hour and 10 minutes, so we're going to do some work on the Glidehammer, and then we're going to kick it on over to her. Because, you know, why not? I had a little bit of time here. I have an infinite amount of work to do. So let's get it. William Barlow, Yawman Flights, Free Lojo, Ken Hill, Arctic Ice Drone. How you guys doing? You're early. You're the people with the you're the people that click the bell icon so that you actually get a quick notification when I do a rando stream. So thanks for that. Much appreciated. Y'all man just got his crossfire. Don't be nervous. Just be confused. Crossfire for some reason just tends to confuse me. So we're gonna probably not be able to do the whole flight controller swap, but we'll at least get to work on it. But first, I've got... Actually, I know exactly what... This is just a lighting thing, but hold on.
Splits.
We haven't had them in a moment.
Got it. Okay. Every time I put this extra little light here, we hear you. Every time I put this extra little light here, it kind of gets in the way. So, but I got a little extra piece of Umagrip. So if I stick Umagrip to the bottom of the little extra light, it won't rotate all over the place anymore. Although the battery did go dead. Well, we tried. Yep. Okay. Well, next time. I guess technically... Oh, wait. No, I got it. I got this. Hold on. We have the technology. No, we don't. We don't have the technology. All right, little guy. You plug in now. One more second, everybody. Just one more second. I swear I'll have my shit together someday. There we go. Okay, that's plugged in. Hopefully it's charging. Yes, it is. Okay. Everything's fine. Don't panic. Nobody ever to pull anything out of my ass. Okay, so yeah, we'll work on the glide hammer, and then we'll go away. Here's what I want to know from you guys. Right now it's got Lumineer Zip 2407 1700s. Would you guys rather see this build on these motors? This is going to be like a high-speed kind of cinematic chase things that are going 70, 80, 90 miles an hour rig. What would you guys rather see, these 2407s or... I have a fresh kit of Joshua's new 2208s, 2208 2400s, which I would just throttle scale down. Eventually I want to put these motors on, but for right now, personally, I would rather have the 2407s because they have that extra stator width, 22 versus 24. What I'm doing with this rig is running like really high pitch props that really need that like grunt. So unless a lot of you want to see the 2208s, it's staying on these 2407s. But yeah, if enough of you are desperate to see Joshua's 2208s, I'll think about it. I probably won't leave them on, but I'm willing to like put them on for a little bit. So let me know. Okay. All right, they're over there now. Next up. Oh wait, I need a little bag again. Where's a little bag? Give me a little bag. Here we go. I've got this bag of motors. I'm putting like one of every motor in this bag. It's kind of interesting. But
it's 7 o'clock.
Some of them are actually I need this. All right, you know what? I'm not gonna have this bag of motors anymore. That's silly. Yeah, I need this. I need this Emax Eco to fix the tiny trainer. You know what? Let's do that right now. Let's do that right now. We can do a quick fix. I just annihilated one of the Emax 1404 6000s. Freelojo, what do you have an extra of? I don't know what I was talking about at the time. Oh, look at that. So this may have happened because, so either one of these screws fell out. What I think happened is that one of these screws fell out and then it took a hit on that corner, and that's what caused the stator to bend so badly. But technically speaking, it could have taken the hit and ripped one of these screws out. It's really hard to tell. Man, this thing sits upside down so nicely. Oh, a JB motor. Now, are you running them? How do you like them?
Or did you just find an extra one that you have no use for? Because if you're running them, keep it. I probably will. I'll probably just like run them to do a little photo shoot and a little review and spend a little bit of time on them. But I'm probably not gonna like smash them and run them really hard. The 2208 size is just, it's just not, I just don't think it's my size. I mean, I haven't flown it yet, so maybe I'll fall in love with them. You never know. But yeah, I'm, my current thought is to just make some content with them and then do a giveaway for them to kind of keep them moving and get them over to somebody that'll use them a little bit more than me, because I really try to, if I'm going to fly 5-inch, I really try to only fly a 2306 rig so that I can get that, so there's something I'm used to. It just, I find my progression as a pilot goes a lot faster when I fly my regular rig over and over and over again. So, like, I love doing the reviews and checking out the new stuff, but, you know what I mean? Like, I probably, unless I fall in love with it, I probably won't put the time into them that they deserve to have, if that makes sense. Who wants to take bets that we won't do anything on the glide hammer? Because I just realized there's another little small job that I wanted to do with the solder iron. And this, right now, switching this motor has already turned into a much... I forgot why I didn't want to fix this. I forgot why I haven't fixed this yet, because getting access to anything on this rig is takes more time than most, because of the canopy and because of everything else. But I still do like the canopy. It's still cool that it's just like a different thing. So don't take this as me talking bad about the canopy. It's just a different build, right? It's just a this build has a different repair cycle, and it's not that bad. I took that top off pretty quick, right? Wasted a couple zip ties, but that's all right. I need some more of these ratchet strappy things, so that I can run them on the front and back, so I don't have to keep wasting zip ties. All right, so there we go. So if I do kind of like a post-mortem, so there was definitely no screw in here, for sure, because those threads are perfect. There very well could have been a screw in there. The threads are, I mean, it's kind of all bent up. And it's interesting how it bent down. You know, I think there was a screw in there, and I think the motor just hit hard enough to bend the... to bend the stator base, which, I gotta be really honest, that's not a good thing. That, in my, well, so I guess I'll put a fourth screw in these. I usually like it when the stator is a little bit thicker than this. And I think if this was a little bit thicker, maybe this wouldn't have happened. I mean, it's not the end of the world, it's a $12 motor, but, you know, in the interest of learning something from this crash, what this sort of says to me is that if you're going to run these Emax 1404s, use four screws. I do three screws on motors because it usually works, especially if you put them in the right spots. So on the front motors, I always run three screws like this, because typically the collisions are going to happen in these directions, and the screws are going to take all the weight, and typically you're not going to get a hit from this direction on this front motor, right? So you can skip this screw and save, I think they're like 0.2 or 0.3 of a gram. It actually does make a little bit of a difference. When you save fractions of a gram in a bunch of different spots, it adds up. So yeah, same thing on this side. And then I'm torn on what I do on the back, because it depends. Like, this isn't a super duper freestyle rig that I would probably fly backwards a lot, so I did the same thing in the back here, and I put them on the front. But usually what I do in the back is I'll run screw here, screw here, screw here, and I'll leave this one empty, assuming that I'm not going to hit the motor from this angle, right? But I'm going to put a fourth screw in all of these, actually, because Yeah, it just looks like maybe this stator base is a little weak, and a fourth screw will really help that. So, yeah, let's do it. So there's our broken. Let's get the prop off. What's creepy is the prop looks completely fine, as does the motor bell, and that's what kind of worries me. If the prop was mangled and or the motor bell had a big old dent in it, then it would be like, all right, well, that stator base deserved to bend, because obviously this took a hell of an impact. But I mean, look at this prop. Like, this prop is fine. This prop is completely fine. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, preloader, that's perfect. Yeah, that's perfect. If I fall in love with them, for sure, send an extra. And I mean, unless, like I said, you don't have a use for it. If you don't have a use for it, then during the giveaway, I'll give 5 away. You know what I mean? But yeah, whatever. I'm sure everything will be fine. But yeah, I'm not going to crash test them. I'm realizing that, and I had this like pipe dream that I would get all these free quads sent to me, and then I would be like the presenter that, I don't know why it's, what, presenter? What does that mean? I thought that it would be fun to be the reviewer that would crash test the balls out of them, but yeah, I don't know. I haven't gotten the only two things that I've gotten have been the Tiny Hawks, and they stopped working on their own. the AIOs stopped working all on their own with those, so I didn't even get a chance to crash test them. But I digress. No, actually, not true. The freestyle is fine. It's just the race that seems to have committed its own suicide pact. I didn't love the way that the freestyle flew, so I just kind of stopped flying it, and now I'm going to do a giveaway with it. Okay, let me chop these down a little bit. I wish I could just push this fucker up far enough, but this is a really tight build. Yeah, I'm just going to chop these down. It's gonna be fine. All right. So we're gonna do some stripping, some tinning, and then some soldering. First off, use your fingernails to strip the silicone off of the wires. Your fingernails will not leave any markings or nick the individual strands of wire in here, which is a good thing. So just use some Oompa Loompa. It helps if you make the following noise when you do this. All right. So here's the noise. So if you make that noise when you're doing it, it definitely, this has been tested, definitely increases the chances that you'll... So the worry is that if you don't dig your fingernails in hard enough, you'll just pull in the silicone, and you can even yank the silicone completely off the wires if you really get it wrong. So it's been statistically proven that by making that noise, you naturally dig your fingernails in harder to prevent that from happening. It's science, man. I don't know. All right. One tinned, two tinned, and three tinned motor wires. Now we're just going to drop them right on the frame, screw them down with 4 screws instead of 3, and away we will go. We can move on to another small little task, and then the glide hammer. So here we go. First one. See if I can get the second one. Usually I move over to tweezers at this point, but these wires are kind of behaving right now, so I think... Yeah, look at that. Can I go... Should I go for three? See if I can get all three without using tweezers. I don't recommend doing this. Use tweezers. This is more of like a challenge. After you've soldered a lot, you can do stupid shit like this. But if you're just starting out, doing stupid stuff like this will drive you crazy because it makes soldering a lot harder, and soldering is already hard in general. It's not hard. It's just kind of awkward and like unfamiliar, right? It's like not... Much like flying, there's no analog. Like, you've never done anything in your life that resembles soldering that would, like, make you any good at it. And this third one just doesn't want to sit as flat as I want it, so I'll do what I should have done in the first place. There we go. Alright. That's better. Three motors soldered up. And... just a little bit. I just left a little bit of extra wire on him to force myself to push this little guy up. Alright, so I think if I remember correctly, I used different length screws. I did. That was a stupid thing to do. So I did lose one of them. Sometimes I do this when on certain motors, typically on the two screw holes that are right on top of the wire exits, sometimes they will be, sometimes the windings of the motor will be also awful close. And where the hell did I get these little short guys? Those are like M2x3s. That's a very rare size. Shit, I might not have any extras of those. Interesting. Well, let's just start screwing screws in and see how close they get to the windings. So this is one of the M2x4s. Oh yeah, I see exactly what's going on. So this tiny trainer frame is only 2mm carbon, and I don't usually build frames that have 2mm arms. And so these are M2x4s. So there's a full 2mm above the carbon of the arm, and yeah, look at that. The threaded stator base, it looks like it's only about 1.5 mm tall. But it doesn't look like the windings are that close. I know you guys can't see this, but I kind of just have to do this off camera. No, I guess they could be. I guess they could sort of be. Ooh, that's a rough one. Okay, well. Is one side worse? It looks like this one side is worse than the other. So let me just try this here. This is going to make putting four screws in these... This actually might be the reason that I only put three screws in these motors. Okay, now, so we're good on this one side. It's only that other side that it looks like the windings are too close. Sorry, I'm having to do this pretty much all off camera here, guys, but it's... Like, it's really hard for me to even see it, so for me to try to get you guys to see it would be kind of pointless. But I think I'm good. I have this short one here that's going in right now, because that's where it looks like the windings are right on top of the hole. And then these other three have just enough room where the screw is peeking out through the threaded part of the stator base, but it's not getting so close to any windings that it's going to jump and cause issues. So this one's okay. This one I can just put an M4 in and or M2x4 in, will be good. So that's a good thing. So that's two arms down. Let me check to see if any of these guys are backing out. No, it seems okay. So that's good. Yeah. I didn't Loctite these. They have some, like, residual Loctite on them. But, alright, so now I'm in the same situation. I gotta kind of, like, look off camera and see how close these guys are coming to know if they're gonna work. That's the little secret short guy. And, yeah, this is the hole that it looks really close on. That's weird. I had that in the wrong... I think when I was installing these motors, I had M2x4s and M2x3s, and I got them a little bit mixed up, because that was a... I had that one in the wrong place. But, I'm just glad that there was one there, because now all I have to do is get another M2x4, which is right here, and we'll have four screws and three motors. There we go. Cool, okay, and then this one is sticking out a little bit here, right, as it should be? Yeah, okay, so that's fine. All right, so the last one is motor number two, and let's see where the short, yeah, I put the short one on the outside again. That's a strange thing to do, but I'm glad that I have a short one. Now I can put it here where it belongs. Oh, I forgot about the chat. You guys are over there chatting up. By the way, in the chat, if you want me to read your message, just type Ciotti FPV somewhere in your message. No spaces, Ciotti FPV. What that's going to do is it's going to light your comment up in orange for me so that A, I see it, and B, I know that you're talking to me as opposed to somebody else in the chat. Starting now, since I've been neglecting you guys for this entire time. No, that's an M2x4. It didn't look like it was sticking through that far. I'm concerned about this screw here, but I don't have any more M2x3s, so and I don't think it's been an issue thus far, so it should be fine. So I'm just going to crank this last M2x4 in here, and that's that. Short one down there where the wires are close. Not so short one there, but in theory we're okay. Actually, I'm going to switch these two. These are both M2x4s, but they have different heads on them, so they're probably made from different manufacturers, and one of them is fractionally shorter than the other. Since, you know, even when we have measurements as a standardization, Chinese companies still find a way to get the standardization wrong. Oh, great. And that just stripped out on me. Awesome. All right, that's better. Cool, so the tiny trainer is back. Oh, kind of back. I still got to do all the reassembly gubbins. Balls. Alright. Where's the canopy? Here it is. Okay, so let's get this on here. Let's get that dropped down there. Do some screwing. Mr. Huggy says there are now arm guards on Thingiverse for the tiny trainer. Really? I love that, except for the fact that I already kind of want it to be lighter. It's already kind of heavy. It I don't know, it kind of feels heavy, I think. Although, you know what, I can't say that. I haven't flown it enough to really make that distinction, so I'm gonna hold off on that. I do love that idea, though, because it's a unibody. And with a unibody, when you completely wreck the ends of your arms, you've got to pull the entire thing apart to swap the base plate, right? You can't just swap an arm out. So that is pretty awesome. I just hope they're not too heavy. I almost always run the TPU arm guards on the front because I have a tendency to scrape the front arms on the ground when I'm just flying really, really low to the ground, which happens like every other battery, every battery. And so I usually put them on the front. I always want to put them on the back, but I don't want the extra weight. Weight on the ends of the arms is the worst possible place to put it. So it's a, it's always a balance of like, I want the most performance, but I don't want to be fixing this thing. You know what I mean? Like, I want a little bit more durability. On individual arms, it's less of a thing. I still do it, though, because I still want as much... because I'm fucking lazy. That's the real reason. But, yeah. I'd rather have a little bit more longevity to the arms and sacrifice a little bit of weight just in the front, just on the front too. But that's stupid. I shouldn't. On the glide frame, it's very easy to change the arms out, and I break the arms pretty often as it is from just huge crashes, so it's really dumb. Like, I should really not run the TPU on the front of the glides. But... I've tried it, and I scraped the arm ends so bad that, like, I end up having to change arms more often, which, again, like, I should just suck that up and change arms more often, because it is a real performance difference, but, yeah, like I said, I'm lazy. I hate anything I can do to increase durability, that's, like, a big thing for me, yeah. And in my brain, I'm like, well, maybe... I know it's an actual difference in performance, but in my brain, I'm like, well, maybe it's not that big of a difference. It is. I'm just being an idiot. Also, I am going to put... I'm going to pull one of the regular glides apart and put the Joshua Bardwell Edition Phoenix in there. I'm kind of getting fed up with Micro Eagles. I had two of them let go in small... grass crashes yesterday. So there it is. Awesome. I gotta remember to add... Hey, Samet, are you in here? I don't think he is. I gotta remember to... actually, I gotta do something real quick. You guys can watch me do it because it's a cool thing that I'm gonna do here. I gotta go to Thingiverse. Samet Kid offered to print some stuff in Violet for me. He got Violet TPU. And... I was like, will you print like a million things for me? He said, yeah. So I really want a set of Tiny Trainer parts. And while I'm at it, might as well get the... Oh, I like these arm protectors. They're like super minimal. That's what I'm talking about. Fuck yeah. Whoever did that, you're awesome. Okay, so there's all the Tiny Trainer stuff. But also, somebody sent me... Oh, man... Somebody finally found on Thingiverse the little wrap strap, 3D printed wrap straps, and I didn't fucking bookmark it or anything. Damn it, and now I'm not going to be able to find them on Thingiverse. Shit sticks. You guys know what I'm talking about? It's what I just put on the arms. They look exactly like the wrap straps that Steel uses, but they're 3D printed. The wrap straps that Steel uses are made in Australia, and they're like expensive to get over here, and they're blue. You can only get them in blue. Although I think somebody just got them in stock, maybe like Pyrodrone possibly, but they're blue. So you know, function over form. No, I mean form over function. Yeah, they're like TPU zip ties. God damn it, but they're thicker. They're what I was just putting on the arm. These things. Wait, what am I doing? See it? Right? They're like that wrap strap material.
They're on Thingiverse. I just... Thingiverse's search is not great. Yo, what's going on, Fraze? Fraze FPV in the house. I swear to God, he was driving that Volvo in the fall at it. It wasn't just a random stranger. Christ. God damn it. What are they called? Farts. Let's try searching for what Freelojo typed. TPU ties. That's a good search term. Yeah, they're very similar. They're very similar to this over here, but not quite... That's not quite it. Locking straps. Ooh, that's another good search. Yapsy sold his QX7, and now he's dead to me. wants a TX16, but my dad won't let me. Ugh. Sucks, man. I did search wrap strap. It did not come up with that. Locking strap, though. That's a really good search. Oh, there's multiple pages here. Come on. Where are ya? QX7 is life indeed. It's worth waiting for, Yapsy. Just keep telling yourself that. That's called being an adult, unfortunately. Like, oh look, a big shit sandwich I'm gonna have to take a bite of. Well, I better tell myself it's not gonna be that bad, or else I'm gonna jump off the balcony to my death. License, did you find it? It looks, do you know what it looks like? In the picture that the person has of it on here, it looks exactly right. You need me to hold it up to the thing again? I can't tell if you guys like know what it is or if you're giving me suggestions on what to search for, so I'm just getting to the end of this search. Alright, well this search is getting less good. I don't know, man. All right, trying locking strap. And then I'm going to try what you said, License. Hey, Jamie Ann, how are you? Jamie, don't worry. I'm sending everybody over your way, myself included, at 8 o'clock. I got your back, yo. I don't like the idea. Like, I did it with bot, too. Like, I don't know. I don't like the idea of bleeding over onto somebody else. We got to, us streamers got to stick together, man. New groups from Treat, and they're way more sticky. What color? Did you get the red and purple ones? Ooh. This girl doing some tie-dye. Shit. Damn it, come on. I need to find this. If I don't find this, I'm gonna lose my mind. I'm trying to think of who I sent it to. Yeah. That's our shared I guess that's our shared color, Jamie. That's great. Come on, go, Thingiverse, go. All right, so that didn't find it. All right, license to drive type something. Let's try that. Customizable cable tie. Just like that. Very similar, but that's not quite it. Oh, damn it. I mean, any of these will probably work, but for whatever reason, I like this one. Sent the shift ones, but the adhesive is just not there, so I went, okay, yeah. He'd told me that, so like I don't know, whenever, 6 months ago when him and I were talking about doing custom colors, he told me that he'll get whatever colors I want in, but different manufacturers use better glue than others. That's one of the things we were kind of afraid of. The purple and red looks better than the color shift, though. Am I right? I'm right. Hey, Brad's calling. Okay, my phone just shut off. Yo, Brad!
That sounded insane. What's up, brother?
Nothing, man. You're on the stream.
Oh, hello, stream.
This is McManus FPV, everybody. Say hello, or else I'll come to your house and attack you in the face.
I don't think they're allowed to call me FPV anymore. I haven't flown in 2 months.
Oh, it's, yeah, his new name is McManus Paint PV.
Yeah.
McManus.
I was painting the basement today.
McManus PTW, Paint the Walls.
No more painting. I was calling to ask about that 4-inch, but I guess you probably covered that.
Oh, perfect. No, we haven't talked about it yet on the stream here today.
Talking about that 4-inch.
Well, I'll do you one better. I will grab the GoPro session, which has a battery that... Dude, the whole stream is about to thank you, and they're all saying hello. But the whole stream is about to thank you because I wouldn't have thought to do this unless you'd said it. I flew a battery on it yesterday with the Session 5 on it, so now we can tell if it's...
Nice.
It felt like a 4-inch carrying session, like it didn't have that 5-inch float, but I don't know, that's not necessarily a bad thing. Like, it felt really... I don't know. Here, I'll show you guys. Where is my stuff? Oh, it's outside. Hold on. Alright, here it is. It's all dirty. Because it was all muddy yesterday. Because it won't stop raining here. Fuck. Yeah, Brad, is your computer set up? Can you actually, like, turn the stream on and see this video?
Oh, yeah, I'm here. I'm watching.
Oh, that's funny. Yo, look. Hold on. Look, it's you. Yo, talk to yourself.
Hello.
I'm surprised it doesn't feed back.
Yeah, when I turned on my computer, I had the sound on. I was surprised it didn't do that either. You're looking at your bench. I finally have my bench all set up.
Do you really?
Moved in.
Sick. For anybody that doesn't know, why would you know? Brad moved from house to house, so that takes time and effort.
Lots, apparently.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Come on up, memory card. And let's move this over. And
what's a Rode wireless?
Wireless mic pack with a lavalier mic, so that when I move to the workbench from in front of the computer, the audio doesn't get all shitty. Basically.
How can I hit up that? How do I give you money? What do I do?
There's a button below the.
Oh, that?
Or just PayPal me, because fucking YouTube takes 30%, those thieves.
I'll just PayPal you.
That's going to also allow me to walk outside and still talk through the stream. And when I get this laptop all up, finally, it'll have the eSheen RF thing on it. So I'll be able to fly out front on the stream with, in theory, like perfect quality video and audio.
Sweet.
Maybe. Or none of it'll work. And I'll light the whole world on fire. All right, here we go.
Hold on, my computer just exploded. So let's go to my other computer. It's fine.
It looks like it might have corrupted the last one anyway.
Oh god, being chased by a giant animal.
Oh no, it's fine. How's the moose doing? Hey, here it is.
Dude, he's gigantic, man.
Let me see what the deal is with the audio here. He's got that floppy face.
He does. He's got like two extra faces.
Well, this is interesting. I can't tell if this is the 4-inch or the 5-inch yet.
Hold on, I think this is
the 4-inch.
How's it feel? Like, how was the battery time?
It's hard to tell because this is a pretty small spot. Wow, yeah, I'm not totally sure. No, that was a 5-inch rig. Okay. The pitch was a little higher than I was used to because that's the rig with the Pro 4s on it.
The Pro 4. Oh, yeah. How are they?
Dude, they're the truth.
Are they really?
Oh, boy.
Have you beat the shit out of them yet? If you don't, you must have. I'm sure you broke 10 of them already.
I haven't, no, because I only have one extra, and I just haven't flown much. It's been very rainy. I think this is the 4-inch.
Oh, yeah, here too.
I finally forgot to put an antenna on my Crossfire module and had a flyaway failsafe.
What?
Yeah, I mean it only flew away for 1 second, but I was on the throttle when it failsafed, so it climbed up into the top of the trees in that 1 second and then fell down through the trees.
That's frightening.
Yeah, it was a little creepy. But I knew I was going to do it eventually. You're the one that said to me that everybody seems to do that at least once.
Yeah, everybody I talked to has done it one time.
All right, yeah, so here it is. This is the 4-inch carrying a GoPro session with, like, zero tuning, pretty much. I moved the P gains on pitch up by 5, and that was it.
Yeah, you can see it. It looks fat.
You can hear it, too.
Yeah. Oh, totally, yeah. It literally sounds doughy.
But
it seems to move pretty good.
It does, dude. Like, it's fine.
Yeah.
And if you do, like, I would almost say in a spot like this, it's maybe better because it doesn't go as fast.
Dude, that was nice. It's like no prop washing. That was like no anything.
Yeah, it felt way.
Is this 4.2?
Yeah, 4.2 with all the tricks. Look at that. It's still floaty. It's still got some float.
Yeah, it does. That stuff's terrible. Yeah, right there, you can see it. Right when you try to bring it back, it's like, ugh!
Yeah. It feels a lot more different than I thought. Like, I was having trouble getting used to it. Not as evidenced by that. That was just me going,
oh,
yeah.
What frame is it in?
What?
What frame are you in?
It's this wacky prototype frame from Bob.
Oh, because it looked like a little tiny wide.
It looks like a mix between a glide and a flow ride. It's got no butt like the flow ride, but then it's got the long dick nose like the glide.
Oh, man, the flow ride, still my all-time favorite frame.
Yeah, it's so good.
This is so good. I mean, it was also the frame I was flying when I, like, actually learned to fly, but still.
Right. But yeah, flies fine, right? Like definitely needs some getting used
to. You know,
to.
In the smaller proximity stuff, it's good. It was the big dive it had trouble with.
Yep.
The little stuff, it gets down on the ground just fine.
And God knows if this is the right amount of KV. Like, this is just a shot in the dark, 3,500 KV. I mean, maybe it needs more KV. Maybe it needs less KV. It's, you know, we're in the land of
make-believe. Yeah, I can't tell if it's a pitch, or they're 1804s, right?
Yep. Maybe an 1805 would be better. You know what I mean? Like, there's just so many variables. It's like, ugh, fuck. Another.
It seems to me like it could use a little more hooch.
I would think so too, but we've managed to pick another prop size that we can start from scratch with and try to fucking.
There's no 19 series motors. Is anybody make like a 20 series?
Yes. There's a bunch of 2004s coming out. I think the Brother Hobby might already have one out.
I mean, I'll tell you what, though. The fact that it's carrying a GoPro...
Pretty fucking impressive, right?
Is impressive.
With, like, no tuning.
Yeah, it's not really struggling. It just, you know...
It's just different. Like, that was the impression
like
I got.
Five inches slow little brother.
Yeah, I was like, this is just different, and I would need to spend some time with it. Hold on, let me mute the chat for a second. How do I do that, even?
Sweet.
All right, we're back. We're back. We're not muted on the chat anymore. I had to tell Brad secrets, guys.
Secrets. Get in there.
All right, so we got 20 more minutes.
That wasn't bad.
No, not at all, dude, right? Like, I'm the only thing that weirds me out is it... There was just... I couldn't figure out what it was, but there was just something...
That was nice.
A little awkward
nice.
About it. Like, I just... I was never really comfortable with it. But, you know, go figure. It's the third time I've ever flown 4-inch. But...
Yeah, it definitely
I don't know.
Flies different.
I was hoping that it would fly exactly like a 5-inch.
It just doesn't spin up as quick.
See, I don't know. I don't know what it is.
It just doesn't have that punch. Like, you can just see it. It's not, it's nowhere near as angry.
I can't believe how much float it has, though. I thought it was going to fall like a safe. And it just doesn't.
No, it doesn't fall like a safe at all.
There was one, when I was playing up in the trees at one point, I let it hear. Like, that was fine. Man, I did have to hammer it to get it back up that tree, though.
You hear it. You can hear it. You're at the top of the throttle.
Yeah. So I guess that's the difference you're actually getting. But see, in a proximity spot like this, you wouldn't use full throttle at all on a 5-inch rig.
No, hell no. Dude, I barely ever use full throttle on a 5-inch rig, period.
Right. Right. Yeah, true.
I don't normally bash the shit out of it. If I bury the throttle, it's probably because I'm in panic mode.
Right.
Yeah, I'm like trying to get it off the water or something.
When you go into the plastic on the fucking with the Pro 4s, the whole world spins in the opposite direction. Metal Dirtskin, it's basically a prototype of that. It doesn't share much in common with it, but yeah, it's the prototype of that frame. Metal.
Oh, the four rod?
Yep.
That's a cool name.
Yep. Oh, four ride. Right. Flow ride. That's funny. I wonder if he did that on purpose, because they both have no butt. Interesting. Huh. All right, I'm gonna do 18 minutes of work over on the bench, brother. Let me. I'm gonna give you a holler tomorrow.
Cool. Talk to you tomorrow.
Later.
Yeah, man. Later, streams.
Peace. All right, everybody. We got 18 minutes, and then we're all gonna hang out with Jamie. Checking the chat. Checking the chat because there was a lot of orange. I still can't find the fucking thing. Yawman Flight says you're not answering. I didn't see that you tagged me. Have you messed with the Happy Model Crazy Bee F4 V3? I have not. I have not used any of the Happy Model electronics, only their motors. Their 0802 25,000 kV motors are awesome. That's the only experience I've had with them, though, so I will not say positive or negative things. Freelojo says, getting the M2x3 screws may... Oh, man. At least I'm not the only one with the dad jokes. Good form, Freelojo. Paulie Lee says, good evening. Mark Kunoff says, durability over anything else. I'm close, man. I am close to being on board with over anything else, but weight is weight. Well, not only that, but there's a point where you can bolt so much shit on that you've added enough extra weight that, like, arms start to break. So I think durability with a consideration to weight over anything else. How about that? That'll be my saying, my version of that saying. All right, we're good, 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 good. Freelojo is on that QX7S train. I'm very jealous of that. I'm waiting for... I want them to make a white QX7S plastic only. Because they on the S, they tilted the switches away, and that's a problem. I have big long fingers, and my knuckles hit the switches. So I just took one of the switches off, which is fine, because I have everything in 8-channel mode, so I don't need all those switches. But it would still be cool for those switches to be canted away. But I'm not going to spend $200 on a QX7S. My QX7 has Hall gimbals, so it's the same thing as an S, just without the switches canted away, and that's not a deal breaker. Adam is on season 3 of IASIP. IASIP. The fuck is that? IASIP. Shit, I don't know what that is. Maybe I'm just old, but I feel like sometimes I'm bad with acronyms. I'm probably just bad with acronyms, and that makes me feel old. How about that? License to Drive says found two cable thingies. Thingiverse. Close, but not quite it. I found those two. I didn't find these, but again, close, but not quite it. God damn it! Where's the? If I go in Facebook. I can probably search for Thingiverse, because I think that's where somebody sent it to me. Maybe. Maybe. Alright, hold on. Maybe. It might be over here. If I just search for Thingiverse. I want to give you guys this link too, because they're really good. This thing works really well. I've been using it from... nice. Thank you, Brad. Very, very cool of you. Brad just sent 75 over via PayPal. Let's get it updated. Math. 149? Right? Oh, shit. Look at that, guys. We're almost there. 149 out of 199, and we'll be wireless. Fucking flying around the house, flying out front, running into parked cars. It's gonna be goddamn great. Thanks, brother. Fucking cool of you. Oh my god, Dave's FPV is watching from the bathroom. He's had food poisoning for the last 3 days. And he thinks that it might have been bad crabs. What the hell? The Never Give Up video gave up. Come on, OBS. You're not... That's... No. You can't give up on me during the Give Up video. That's not cool. Fuck. Jesus. Alright, well, I mean... Brad, have you seen my new intro yet? Here. Where's it at? Goes on like that, and so on and so forth, and so on and so forth. Man, OBS is acting really weird. Yeah, Yapsy, that's I'm actually about a year and a half behind on edits, so the fact that that edit was from fall of 2019 rather than fall of 2018 is kind of a miracle. Most of the 2018 stuff, when I go to edit it, I'm like, no, I sucked in 2018. So I'll at least go to like 2019. Mr. Huggy says it looks more like flying an 8 to 10 inch prop. It's the 7 inch of micro quads. Yeah, could be. My thought process on it is with the smaller props, it will naturally fly slower. So for a smaller spot, exactly like that. But then the flip side is that 5 inch rigs just have this like magical, super secret witchcraft, black magic ability to do everything perfect, like fly small spots like that. Because after that I moved the GoPro to a 5-inch rig and it was better in that spot. I'm beginning to understand why nobody has done anything with 4-inch builds yet, but that doesn't mean I'm not going to, because when I had it with just the RunCam Hybrid, it was a fucking weapon. And it would be cool to be able to have RunCam Hybrid footage with it as a weapon, and then for whatever reason, if I need to carry a Session 5, I can. So, like, I guess maybe for, like, a one-quad-only kind of thing. If you're going on vacation, you want to pack as light as possible. TBS Tango, 4-inch rig with the foam up front. Bring a Session to get like B-roll or just, you know, whatever memories, and then yeah, you've got something that you can fly as a weapon and get RunCam Hybrid footage from. And RunCam Hybrid footage looks really good, not quite as good as a Session 5, but and then you can put a Session 5 on it and fly it like a Cinewhoop ish but with a little bit more pop than a Cinewhoop. I don't know, What I will say is, in terms of carrying a Session 5, the 4-inch rig does a way better job than a 3-inch rig. I've had the Session 5 on the Acrobrat a bunch of times, and like when you hop off the throttle, that fucker drops like a safe. I mean, it really falls out of the sky. What's going on, Artemis? How are you, man? That could be the use for 4-inch, right? One quad to rule them all. Isn't that from a show? 100 people's heads just exploded as they realized that I refuse to watch Game of Thrones. I don't even know the name of it. That's how little interest in I have in one of the best television shows ever made. At least I'm kind enough to say that, right? Even though I don't believe it. And everyone's heads exploded. I'm still looking for this goddamn thing. Oh, I see what's going on. I didn't realize that. Facebook's chat is the worst. The worst. Why can't you just say hello or what's up? Facebook search will not, when I search for Thingiverse, it will not find www.thingiverse.com links. So I'm never going to, oh, not me. No, the fists are required. I'm all for that. Okay, so I'm never gonna find them, ever. What the hell? You guys know what it looks like, right? Here's what it looks like. Alright, this is gonna have to be a collective job, because I can't fucking find it. I will make sure that maybe I did like it. Hold on, there is a chance that I liked it. There is a chance. BMC3D sells it. I'm very glad that Jamie's going on at 8. Because it is getting very hot in here. My wife Kristen's best friend in the world, Jen, is over. So I actually shut the doors for a change in here. And this tower has a great second life coming to it when I'm done with it as a fucking heater. Because my word, does it put out some goddamn heat. Okay, collections. And so there is a chance. There is a chance that I saved it in here, but I guarantee you that I didn't. This is like, on Thingiverse, there's like a bookmark set. Yeah, I did not save it in here. You can like bookmark shit, and I forgot to. Did I maybe like it? Nope, of course not. All right, so here's what we're looking for, Collective. If you guys want to be super awesome ninja fucking Sherlock people, you can. If you can find it, then you'll have my never-ending adoration. That's what we're looking for. It's on Thingiverse, but that's what it is. It works really well. I want to share the link with you guys so that you can print them. And I don't know. You can do it. No, Artemis, same side. Or wait, no, I mean Yapsy, same side. Artemis was down here at the BLM protest 2 Saturdays ago. And went so hard that he couldn't walk for like 2 days afterwards. So, same side. Fellas. Keep it civil. This is what we're looking for, though. So, yeah, if you guys want to help me out, I would love it. If not, that's cool, too. I wouldn't. I wouldn't help me out either. Oh, shit. All right, so cool. I just had to remind myself to ask Cement Kid to do that with that stuff.
Oh, you don't agree, Yapsy. Oh, okay. Well then, yeah, you're not in the right place. Because we believe in it here and are very much behind it. So, you're more than welcome to stay, but you're not going to get support from many people here on that side. And I will leave it at that. I will do the adult diplomatic whatever thing and say that, you know, everybody has a right to have their own opinion. Some of those opinions I personally, you know, find wrong, but that's okay. We live in a free country, luckily. It's a real blessing to live in a country where we can say that and where that can be the truth, because in other spots in the world, that's not the case. You have to hide your beliefs. Tiny Trainer works. Look at that. Okay, so let's not even fuck around with the glide hammer. We're just gonna do this real quick. This is a barrel plug charger thing, but my Q6 from ISDT only has an XT60 lead, so we are going to chop and XT60 this fella. But all of that being said, all of those political things being said, we try our best to keep politics out of here. I'm not great at that, admittedly, but yeah, everybody is more than welcome to stick around. Just understand that, yeah, every so often I'll go on a rant, and if the content and the friendship is worth a rant that you might not agree with, but that half of the country agrees with every so often, then, and this isn't you, Yapsy, I'm talking to everybody, then yeah, I would love for everybody to stay, but if not, I totally understand. No big deal. Unless you're friend, that is my stance here on the open and free internet. Another thing that we can't remember is we're very lucky to have an open and free internet. That's my stance here. Fair warning, that is not my stance if you become a friend of mine in real life, for the record. And it helps when the soldering iron is turned on. I choose my friends. One of the big things that means a lot to me is moral values. And yeah, a lot of these issues can get into moral values pretty quickly. And again, that's okay. We're something that I've learned in therapy multiple times is that we're allowed to have deal breakers and we're allowed to structure our own lives the way that we see fit. And this is the way that I choose to have my life. The people that I let in closest to me, go figure, are the people that have similar values to me. I certainly have friends that are Republicans, but my best friends are more morally centered with me. Which I think all of us can say. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe not. Who am I, right? I'm just a dude. Just a dude on the internet. His fucking phone won't stop quacking. Shut up, phone! Shut up! I do have Discord. Scroll down a little bit. You'll see it. You'll see a link to it. All right. It's 8 o'clock. Let's go watch Jamie. Who's got the link? Who has the link? I'm trying to get to the link. All right. I'm gonna remove that one. Just because I'm not
Yeah. I'm just going to remove that one, and that's it. There she be. All right, here you guys go. Everybody go on over, and life goes on, man. I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'll be back. Go watch Jame. Goodbye. Here comes Clam Man.
もう少し頑張ってみろよ。ダメダメダメ、諦めたら周りのことを思うよ。応援してる人たちのこと思ってるのって。俺だってこのマイナス10度のところ縮みがずっと頑張ってんだよ。絶対っていうの必ず目標達成できる。だからこそ夢がビバ